Limerick Today with Joe Nash on Limerick's Live 95 FM.
And Drake, August and Sprid Nave, Amen. Gorev and Tierna live. Cade me la fall to Roy Gwalair. Good evening, Afrin Shaw. Archbishop Kieran here present. Archbishop Emeritus Dermot. Brother priests, all join with me wholeheartedly, as already expressed by Father James, in welcoming every one of you here present. And in particular, of course, the Lord's Mother Eileen, siblings, her children, numerous relations and friends, and many, many, many others. Caid Míle Fáil to Roy Gwalair. And now, friends, we pause for a second, and if the symbols of that lovely lady's life are being presented, as Father James will, to give a little commentary on each.
So, two symbols of Dolores' musical career. A guitar and a Platinum Disc Award will now be brought to the altar by her niece Eileen and also by a lifelong friend, Teresa. Dolores' nephew Patrick will now present a picture of Our Lady of Dolores, after whom Dolores was named, and the picture originally belonged to the great-great-great-grandmother of Dolores. And finally, Brefni, a lifelong friend of Dolores from primary school, will present a book of poetry.
We are here at the funeral mass of Dolores O'Riordan in the village of Ballybricken. What you heard at the start there was a recording of Dolores and Pavarotti.
Now, friends, we just pause for a moment in silence. Now, silent we have been, and as a mark of respect for the lovely lady who's gone before us, we pause again and look into our own lives, express sorrow for the faults and failings we are conscious of.
That CD was played at
Lord,
the start.
You came among us to save us from sin. A hirna dentro kire. A hirna dentro kire. Lord, you laid down your life for us while we were still sinners. A Christ dentro kire. Lord, you are the resurrection and the life. Ahirna dentro kire.
Ahirna dentro kire.
Let us pray. O God, Almighty Father, our faith professes that your Son died and rose again. Mercifully grant that through this mystery, your servant Dolores, who has fallen asleep in Christ, may rejoice to rise again through him. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. Now we have the readings from Sacred Scripture.
The first reading you're going to hear will be read by Dolores' sister, Angela. The psalms are going to be sung by her nieces Katie and Noel.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. The souls of the virtuous are in the hands of God. No torment shall ever touch them. In the eyes of the unwise, they did appear to die. Their going looked like a disaster. They're leaving us like annihilation. But they are in peace. If they expressed punishment as men see it, their hope was rich with immortality. Slight was their affliction. Great will their blessings be. God has put them to the test and proved them worthy to be with him. He has tested them like gold in a furnace and accepted them as a holocaust. They who trust in him will understand the truth. Those who are faithful will live with him in love. For grace and mercy await those he has chosen. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want. Fresh and green are his pastures, where he gives me repose.
The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want.
Near restful waters he leads me, to revive my drooping spirit. He guides me along the right path. He is true to his name.
The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want.
If I should walk in the valley of darkness, no evil would I fear. You are there with your crook and your staff. With these you give me comfort.
The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want.
Surely his goodness and kindness will follow me all the days of my life, In the Lord's own house shall I dwell forever and ever.
The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want.
Second reading, a reading from the first letter of Saint John. We ourselves have known and put our faith in God's love towards ourselves. God is love, and anyone who lives in love lives in God, and God lives in him. Love will come to its perfection in us when we can face the day of judgment without fear, because even in this world we have become as he is. In love there can be no fear, but fear is driven out by perfect love, because to fear is to expect punishment, and anyone who is afraid is still imperfect in love. We are to love then, because he loved us first. Anyone who says, I love God, and hates his brother, is a liar, since a man who does not love the brother that he can see cannot love God, whom he has never seen. So this is the commandment that he's given us, that anyone who loves God must also love his brother. The word of the Lord.
Second reading there,
stand out to read the gospel. Alleluia, alleluia. Our homeland is in heaven, and from heaven comes our Saviour that we are waiting for, the Lord Jesus Christ. Alleluia. And so the Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to his disciples, when the Son of Man comes in his glory, escorted by all the angels, then he will take his seat on his throne of glory. All the nations will be assembled before him, and he will separate men one from another, as a shepherd separates sheep from goats. He will place the sheep on his right hand and the goats on his left. Then the king will say to those on his right hand, come you whom my Father has blessed, take for your heritage the kingdom prepared for you since the foundation of the world. For I was hungry and you gave me food. I was thirsty, you gave me drink. I was a stranger and you made me welcome. Naked and you clothed me. Sick and you visited me. In prison and you came to see me. Then the virtuous will say to him in reply, Lord, when did we see you hungry and feed you, or thirsty and give you drink? When did we see you a stranger and make you welcome, naked and clothe you, sick or in prison and go to see you? And then the king will answer, I tell you solemnly, in so far as you did this to one of the least of these brothers of mine, you did it to me. The Gospel of the Lord.
Limerick Today with Joe Nash on Limerick's Live 95 FM. Limerick Today with Joe Nash on Limerick's Live 95 FM.
Canon Liam McNamara will now give the homily, a close friend of the O'Riordan family, and he's acting as chief celebrant here today with Father James Walton.
Friends, this Irishman was very popular in the local community. All look forward to his performance on stage, usually annually. Why? Because his songs were jovial and gave a great laugh. But sadly, the news came through one morning that he had died suddenly, and nobody could replace him. He was terrified out of his wits when he joined the queue facing the divine judge. He felt he had done nothing really worthwhile in life. And there he could see, the back of the queue, he could see Christ in front there, flickering through the various books of life for people. he could hear clearly how those in front of him were doing. He could hear the Lord saying, I was hungry and you gave me food. Yes, you did that. Into heaven. And then he'd say, I was in prison and you paid me a visit. Yes, that's there. Into heaven with you. And that terrified my friend, terrified him, because he had never reached out to anybody to feed the hungry. He had never visited a prison. Back of his head, he said, well, maybe I should have been in prison myself. He was frightened. How am I going to do when my book of life is opened? Eventually, it became his turn, and there he was in front of the Lord, and the Lord flickered through his book and, yeah. Not very much here, the Lord said, not very much here. Oh, wait, he says, there's something over here. Wait, no, there is. There's something here. There is. It says here that I was sad, and I was lonely, and I was down, and I felt nothing. And your funny songs cheered me up and gave me a good reason to have a laugh. In you go. Yes, friends, I suppose the little story is simple. But it clearly indicates the divine mercy of the Lord. And also, even the smallest little virtue, the smallest little act of kindness that we show is actually recorded in our book of life. And, of course, will be rewarded by the Lord at the end. The little story is apt here, I suppose, today, in a sense, when we celebrate the funeral mass of our dearly beloved Dolores. Very apt. And when she closed her eyes to this dark world, indeed which it is, and opened them in the brilliant light of eternity, how filled with joy she must have been. Yes, as she gazed at her own book of life, outlining in detail the numerous ways that she lived the gospel which Father James proclaimed a moment ago. The gospel she proclaimed, and that gospel was chosen specially for her. Yes, our friend in the story reached out to the local community, to his own little community. But of course, Dolores, as it were, reached out to the world. Our good friend, as it were, Dolores, we think of today, our good parents, Eileen and Terry, her numerous relations, no, they weren't proud. Pride didn't enter that family. They weren't proud. But most grateful to Almighty God to have such a privilege of a special daughter, a special sister, a special granddaughter, a special cousin, a special neighbour in the community. She certainly put her lovely, lovely local community, which is steeped in goodness, the lovely community of Ballybricken, she put that lovely community very much on the map. And not only, of course, as you know, the city of Limerick, but the entire county of Limerick as well. And for that, we are very glad. Her kind personality and her beautiful singing voice, which has been heard all over the world, earned for her numerous admirers and numerous followers. It must be added that the numerous people that she rescued from darkness and from sadness in their own lives, she did indeed rescue many, that number would be impossible to count. Impossible. No words chosen by me are adequate to describe Dolores or to accurately state the influence for good which she had over the years, throughout the world. I remember well my first meeting with the lovely girl in 1989 when I came here as parish priest that year. The memory I have is indelibly written in my mind. There in that side aisle, here she was, sitting there at the keyboard, playing music and singing with the choir. Yes, Father John Dwyer, a very good friend of the family. Yes, may his gentle soul rest in peace. Was it a wise appointment that he made, putting Dolores as organist, as instrumentalist in the choir? She possessed a very special singing voice, we all know that, and a talent worth its weight in gold, definitely. Intelligent girl as well, we know that too. And she knew well that if she had a talent, well, she had a duty to develop it. She also knew that talents were given from Almighty God to be used generously in the service of others, fellow pilgrims on the road of life, which she used. She did share the view of Martin Luther King. You're quite familiar with Martin Luther King, the lovely things he wrote. And he wrote that each of us has a duty to work earnestly and discover the kind of talents we have. And then having discovered them, we must try to develop them. And then, as already said, in Dolores' life, to use them for the benefit of other people on the difficult pilgrim way of life. Yes, Dolores had too an inquiring mind, and she could ask you anything. You always had to be ready for her. And one day she said to me, she says, I wonder, could you tell me anything about, she says, Saint Gregory the Great? Of course, I wasn't offhand, had much clue, so I went home and I read it up. And he was a pope, of course, and he was a doctor of the church as well. And he did have a great interest, as you probably know, in church liturgy and in church music, and standardised to the use of chant in the church. The reason why we call it Gregorian chant. That's why she was interested. She was interested in Gregorian chant. In her visits to the various monasteries throughout the country, be it Mellory or be it near at home, Glenstall or Rossgray or whatever, she loved to listen to the monks chant Vespers and Compline. She loved it. Monasteries had a special appeal to her. Perhaps it was the heavenly odour, if you like, of monasticism in Holy Cross that prompted her to celebrate her marriage in Holy Cross Abbey in 1994. Yes, she did have a unique respect, very important, a deep respect for everybody. Everybody was respected, no matter who they were or what they were. What a great privilege to have. And with that respect, her kind and her loving and her generous heart made her a source of great hope to the church during its stormy years, and as well I know that. Everybody doesn't know it, but I know it. She's a great person to give a little word, give a bit of hope. Speaking personally, it wasn't unusual for her to come up beside you and whisper into your ear a little word of support or encouragement or advice. She often said to me, well, she says, whisper in a whisper voice, she says, mind yourselves, I want priests, she said, around while I'm still there. Yes, how happy she should be today to see priests here that she loved, and all priests were respected by her, see them here present today. Very happy she should be. Of course, friends, no matter how strong our faith and our hope, this is a very difficult day, not just for Ballybricken, but for the world. It's a sad day for Eileen and for the entire O'Riordan family. For all those possessions and strong faith, if all of us did have the strong faith that Eileen possesses, as we know, we would certainly understand better the fact that Dolores is with us no longer in a spiritual way, in a real way. Now she is singing in the heavenly choirs, hymns, I say, of petition for yourselves and myself. And don't we need them? Yes, being human, of course, we still miss and will miss her gentle voice, her loving smile and her warm shake hands. We'll miss all these things, being human. Now, sympathies. Sincere sympathy to our good mother Eileen. As somebody called her 24/7, Good Samaritan, to everybody. And that's no lie, we all know from experience. Always reaching out to others. Her siblings, Brandon, Terence, Donal, PJ, Joseph, and Sister Angela. Her nephews, her nieces, her in-laws, her relations, and numerous friends, and the whole locality, the whole area of Ballybricken, Barmore. To you, we say from our hearts, sincere sympathy. To the children that she dearly loved and who dearly loved her. We mention Donnie today, Taylor, Molly, Dakota, and your father, Don, a very good father, as Eileen has many times said, a very good father. To you, we say, sincere sympathy. To those who were part of her life, of course, the Cranberry bandmates, Noel, Mike, and Fergus, it's tough for you too. We'll always remember you. Sympathies from the heart. Friends, we all share in the pain of bereavement from time to time with the O'Riordan family. We're with them in bereavement. And bereavement is a very deep and a very tender and a very sore wound, very slow to heal. In our sorrow today, St. Paul gives us a little bit of consolation. St. Paul does. It's a favourite little word of my own. He's referring to Christ, he said, by his wounds we are healed. By the wounds of Christ we are healed. Healed physically, mentally, psychologically, spiritually. It is our sincere prayer from the heart at this Mass that by his precious wounds, healing will begin without delay in your lives. And also strengthen your hope that our beloved Dolores is now reunited with her lovely father, Terry, who loved her so much and whom she loved so much. Also her little baby brother, Gerard, whose anniversary, of course, today, her grandparents, her relations, her friends, her neighbours, and all she ever knew. Reunite with all them. And there she is in the presence of them, and the presence of the Lord, and the presence of Our Lady of Dolores, after whom she's called, in the heavenly kingdom, where there's no more pain or suffering or separations, no, but only joy and peace for all eternity. Humanly speaking, we're all shedding tears today. But if there are tears shed in heaven, humanly speaking, they have to be tears of joy. Joy, yes, tears of joy for Dolores herself, following an excellent performance by Dolores in the most important and vital gig of life, the gig of life itself. Eriesde Gorev Ahanam. In Anamanar, Alus and Vic, Alus and Spridnave, Amen. And our friends, we invite forward the people who are reading the prayers of the faithful.
Giving a homily to Dolores O'Riordan. He spoke about her special voice, as she was a special neighbour and a daughter of Ballybricken Village, but County Limerick and Ballybricken on the map. We now hear from Dolores' five godchildren, Brandon, Colum, Gerard, Luke and Megan.
Heavenly Father, on this the occasion
we'll
of
give the prayers of the
funeral mass of our beloved Dolores.
The late St. John Paul II occupied a special place in the heart of Dolores. As we pray for all young people in today's world, may his words be indelibly written in their hearts. Christ is the answer to all our questions and the solution to all our problems. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
From the heart, we remember those who were very special and supportive to Dolores. Her loving mother, Eileen, her siblings, her children, Danny, Taylor, Molly, Dakota, and their father, Don. Her numerous relatives and her Cranberries bandmates, Noel, Mike, and Fergal. Lord, hear us.
We pray for Archbishop Kieran, Archbishop Emeritus Dermot, all priests and religious. May the Lord give them all the guidance they need to continue proclaiming the good news of salvation. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We remember Dolores' father, Terry. May she be reunited with him and all the other relatives and friends, where there is no more sorrow or weeping or pain, but only eternal happiness in the kingdom of heaven. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for the sick, especially those who suffer from mental illness. May the Lord heal them and may they receive the understanding and support of their families, neighbours and society at large. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us. Our Blessed Lady herself, Our Lady of Dolores, of course, knows well what bereavement and sadness is all about. So we place the family in the hands of Our Lady of Dolores today, as we say from the heart, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
We will now have the offertory procession.
Now, friends, we have the offertory and the gifts for the Mass or bread and wine are now presented, please.
They will be presented by Dolores' nephew, Jamie and Ben. You're currently hearing the Irish Chamber Orchestra Quartet playing the offertory music there, a quartet that the Cranberries and Dolores O'Riordan have played with previously. In the backdrop of St. Mary's Cathedral on New Year's Eve here in Limerick City in 2013 for Culture 2020. They've also worked with the band last year, releasing Something Else. And this string quartet will play music throughout the Mass here today, having previously played with Dolores and the Cranberries.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant, Dolores, we beseech your mercy that she who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Saviour may find in him a merciful judge. Grant this through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
With
lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
Right
Truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Jesus Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be enrolled by the promise of immortality forever. Indeed, for your faithful people, Lord, life is changed, not ended, and when the earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with the angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we say, Holy, holy, O Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives your praise. For through your only Son, Jesus Christ, by the power of working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice has been offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, for the same Spirit, graciously make holy the gifts that you have brought to you for consecration, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. As we celebrate these mysteries, for on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving thanks, said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, once again giving thanks, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, till you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his passion and death, and by the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension to heaven, and as we look forward to the second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Lord, we pray upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to the world, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with the Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, Saint Ailbe, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help.
With this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in charity and faith your pilgrim church on earth, your servant Francis, our Pope, Cyril, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own.
Listen graciously to the prayer of the family here present, whom you have summoned before you. At your compassion, O Lord Jesus, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant, Dolores, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant to her, who was united with your Son in the death of life, may also be one with him in resurrection, when from the earth she will be raised up and flesh from the dead and be transformed into our lowly bodies from the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, grant kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the kingdom of your glory, when you will wipe away the tears from every cheek. For seeing you, our God as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages, and praise you without end, through Christ our Lord, through whom you become, bestow upon us and the world all that is right. Through him, with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. Amen, 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 amen. Guimish Conanahar, Fe Maravun, or Stanahor Fein, Aro, or Nahar, the Tarnav. In April Canum, the dog of the Rips, and into the hell on Donald, Marnitha now, on Ron the Hool, to doing you, a smart wee mocky, probably him made our way road for him. Snorlish and a go who, Oxerish and all. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, graciously grant peace in our days. With the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we wait the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, said to your apostles, peace I leave you and my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns for ever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let's offer her sincerely that sign of peace.
God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you.
I just give communion to the priest.
We're here in Ballybricken for the
behold
funeral.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
And as we go
Lord,
to the
I am not worthy
prayer.
To receive you under my roof.
The sun is currently shining on down in Saint Ailbe's church here at the moment. A beautiful and personal homily given
just
there by Canon Liam McNamara.
Canon Liam will give communion to those here in the centre aisle. If you'd come up in a single line and then return in a single line. Those in the side aisle, if you would, the archbishops will stand at either corner to give you communion. The altar service will start you off. You come up one side and back around the other side. And Eucharistic ministers will give communion to those at the back of the church and in the yards back in front.
The Irish Chamber Orchestra Quartet just starting to play an instrumental piece here during communion. As mentioned earlier, having previously played with Dolores during Culture 2020 with St Mary's Cathedral as the backdrop in Limerick City. And last year worked with the band on their album Something Else. The quartet featured on their hits and three new songs. As I mentioned, the sun is shining down right now here in St Ailbe's Church in Ballybricken. Earlier it was grey, and as the Mass started, it broke through the clouds. Symbols of Dolores' life were brought up to the altar, representing her musical career, a guitar, a platinum disc award was brought by her niece Eileen and lifelong friend Teresa, Dolores' nephew Patrick presented a picture of Our Lady of Dolores, after whom Dolores was named. And the picture actually originally belonged to the great-great-great-grandmother of Dolores. And Breffni, another lifelong friend of Dolores, presented a book of poetry, all symbols brought to the altar, to represent the life of Dolores O'Riordan. As mentioned, a cherished daughter of Limerick, cherished here in the community of Ballybricken, cherished in Limerick, around Ireland, and by many around the world, for her music and her lyrics. Opening the Mass, we heard her voice along with Pavarotti, which was actually recorded at a charity concert in Italy in 1995, and that played out, reverberated through Saint Ailbe's church here, a small church fitting only about 200 people, but could be heard far and wide today. Her sister Angela gave a reading and a beautiful responsorial psalm sung by Dolores' nieces Katie and Noelle, and that lilt in their voice, that musicality that obviously runs through the family, could be clearly heard today during that. A reading read by her nephew Alan. As we know, Dolores has six siblings, so a large family here today celebrating her life. Her five godchildren also gave prayers of the faithful: Brandon, Cullum, Gerard, Luke and Megan. And a beautiful homily by Canon Lee McNamara. He spoke about Dolores' love for music from her early life, how she played the organ in the choir, and how she had a special voice. He'd known her since 1989 and spoke about how she rescued a lot of people through her lyrics and her music. He spoke about her inquisitive mind and said there were no adequate words to describe Dolores O'Riordan, her intelligent mind, her musicality, and how kind she was, how she put her community here of Ballybricken and the city and county of Limerick on the map.
Limerick Today with Joe Nash on Limerick's Live 95 FM.